So guys, to start with this, first we need to install PHP onto the Omega 2, and to do that I am going to use SSH, and for that first connect to the Omega 2 by using the access point and all. So let's connect to the Omega 2 SSID or the IP and open up PuTTY, type in the Omega 2 IP, or you can use the Omega 2 domain, that is omega hyphen last four digits of MAC ID dot local. So you can simply navigate with 192.168.3.1, that is the default IP address of Omega 2 point and all. Click on yes and use your credential, that is default user is root, password is onionear. So you can see a terminal like this. Now to install PHP onto the system, let's first do a system update by using the command opkg update, and it will just refresh the repositories. And to continue with the installation, use the command opkg install php 7, then php 7 cgi. Right now the version of PHP supported is php 7, so hit enter. And it will install few packages like libxml and all php 7, php 7 cgi and all to the Omega 2. So wait for few minutes till it get completed. So we have installed PHP 7, and if you want to run some PHP scripts by using the terminal or command line itself, you can use or install PHP 7 client. So if you are interested, you can install it by using the command opkg install PHP 7 then CLI. So using this PHP 7 client, you can run your PHP scripts by using the command line. And for the time being, if you are running PHP and all on Omega 2, you can't have access to databases and all, because the resources required for database and all support is not there in Omega 2. So if you want to run some database and all, you want to save data and all, you need to have some online or cloud services to store your data. So locally you can't have any such feasibility and all for the time being. Now after this, you just need to config the USDTPD configuration. And if you are like interested to know more about it, like what is USDTPD configuration and all, you can navigate to the website for which I have given the links down below in the description. So for the time being, let's do it /etc/config/usttpd. You can edit over here like this by using the vi editor. So to insert, let's go with I, and over here you need to add couple of lines, that is like this list interpreter, that is .php equals user bin /phpcgi, and the default index page is index.php. So let's save it by using the command. Now press escape, use the command colon wq, and it will modify the HTTPD configuration file. So make sure it is there. And other way of doing it is, like, you can open up any like FTP application you are using, like WinSCP or something, and just use the IP of your Omega 2 name, that is root, then password. You can save it if you want to save password too, then open up login. Yes, and as you have logged in as like root user, will have access to all files and folder, so you can definitely get into this particular folder etc httpd config httpd, and you can modify it over here if you want, or otherwise you can have the command line interface and you can edit like that. Now we are all set, and let's restart the server to make it effective and all. So to do that, I can use the command /etc/init.d /usttpd, then restart. This will restart the server, and after that let's put some simple scripts or PHP scripts into the www folder, which you can run by navigating to the IP address of your Omega 2. So to do that, get into www folder, and over here create a folder, let's say PHP, click on OK. Let's create some text file over here, .php, and we'll have a simple PHP script that will print hello world. Echo. Now let's open up the browser and check if we are able to run this script on the Omega 2. To do that, navigate onto the IP address of your Omega 2 slash the folder that where we have created our script. And you can see it is printing out, we did it. That means the script has been successfully run. Now let's try to access the GPIOs of Omega 2 from PHP and all. And to get started with this, we need one library, that is over here PHP, like omegaonion.php and all. So first let's copy this thing, or you can directly download this to your Omega by using Git and all. But right now I'm just going to copy this file. I'll be just saving it to desktop. Click on save. Okay. Now open up your WinSCP and all. Get into desktop or where you have saved your file. Okay. Just you got the file. Now upload it to the same PHP folder, and we need to edit the index.php file, and over here we need to create a object of this particular class, that is Omega Onion, that is using, let's say, onion, or you can have a name like GPIO equals new, then Omega Onion, and it takes one parameter, that is you want to log or like debug and all. So we are right now using false, And to check out default available functions with this library, you can simply open it up by using any text editor and all, and you can check out through different like functions available over here. So let's get into like writing GPIO, because we are going to interact with the onboard RGB LED over here. So you can see something like write GPIO and like set GPIO direction. So these are two functions that is of our interest, and to run this and to use this, first we need to use like GPIO, then we need to use the command or the function set GPIO direction. Then it takes two parameters, that is the GPIO, for our case let's say 17, and we are going to make it out. And the next function that we need is like write GPIO. And it takes again two values, that is the GPIO number, for our case it is 17, and the value that we want to write into, like it takes 1 or 0. So let's say we want to make the LED glow, we need to pass 0. And you can have all these functions over here, like you can control relay shield or relay add-on board, initialize relay, and all those things like set. You can directly use set RGB LED, and you can pass off the like value, and accordingly it will on or off the LEDs on the Omega 2 expansion dock. So let's again try to like visit the previous link, and it should glow. Okay, it says this is not found. Oh, I just forgot one thing, that is I need to include the particular file, this omegaonion.php. So I'll use this require ones omegaonion.php. Let's again try to refresh this page, and it shouldn't. Okay, I'll just remove this thing from here, and let's again try it if it works. Now I can see as we visit this page over here, the red LED should glow. Now let's change the script and just make it 16, and it should turn on the green LED. Let's again visit this page, and you can see it has turned on the green LED. So like that you can like check out different LEDs and all, or GPIOs and all, and you can access the GPIOs. This library also supports for PWM and some sleeps command and all. It also helps you to read GPIO status, so you can do basic input and output along with relay and all. Yet I2C or SPA or other interfaces are not there in this library, but you can develop it if you want. Okay. And you can write your simple scripts over here, and you can execute it in your Omega 2. So it depends again on your applications and all, and the script will change, but the overall process remains same, and you can do like this. And if you want to run your PHP script from command line, you can do that by using PHP CLI. And to do that, you can use the command PHP CLI, then path to your PHP file, that is www/php/index.php or whatever file you want to run. And this will also result in, and this will also yield the same result as like browsing the particular file from any browser and all. So you can check both the ways. So that's all with this, guys. Hope you have enjoyed it, and if you have liked it, you can hit the thumbs up button definitely. And if you have not subscribed yet, you can subscribe to my channel for latest updates in your inbox. So see you next time in my next video. Till then, goodbye.